Hey everybody, it's Pete from minigames AAA.com bringing you yet another edition of the Great Digital TCG Search of 2014. I'm sure there's an acronym for that, not one that I could think of on the spot. My brain doesn't work that quickly. This week I am back bringing you yet another card game, this one browser-based game, free-to-play, called War of Omens. Now, what is War of Omens? You're wondering, you're asking yourself, you were saying, Pete, please tell me about this game. And I will oblige, only because I'm obligated to, by our sponsors, Peanut M&M's. Let's see. War of Omens is a combination of two things. It is both a digital TCG and a digital DB... G, which is a deck-building game. So if you're not familiar with deck-building games, then the concept is that each game you start out and you are in the process of making your deck as the game is played. So in traditional TCGs, you go in and you go in with a preset deck that you have that you draw cards from immediately and you begin to play in the game. In a deck-building game, along the lines of Dominion, you are buying cards from like a common pool that you then add into your deck, which then gets shuffled in and you draw cards out of there. In this game, both players start out with a stack of 10 cards that they select, a deck that they can build, and with those 10 cards they go in and that becomes the pool you can buy from. If you're not familiar with any of this stuff, you're probably like, Pete, you're making no sense. You're talking way too quickly for me right now. And that's fine. I don't really particularly care what you think. War of Omens, really interesting. So, to be honest, the way I did this whole search, organizing the games I was going to be doing and playing, was that I wanted to have the four games I knew about, which were Hearthstone, Infinity Wars, Scrolls, and Soulforge, okay? But I wanted to then have four other games, because a bracket of four teams is just horrible. So I added in Faria, Hex, War of Omens, and one other game that I always forget the name of. So look for those, especially that last one. That one is going to be a fascinating experience. But War of Omens has kind of like been of interest to me now that I've started playing it. I came from kind of like a board game background. Sorry, I'm shifting around a bunch. The game I really got started on was Dominion, which, to those of you who don't know, Dominion is actually a really, really popular board game, amongst like kind of an indie gaming scene, but it started to see retail sale. Great game to play with friends, like family. It's fantastic, easy to pick up and learn, and it kind of derives itself from what would be considered a Magic draft, okay? Well, the only thing I didn't like about Dominion is that I love deck building. Like, I would say half of my enjoyment of these games, these TCGs, is the fact that I get to design a deck with an overlying strategy. I've always been fascinated by it, and I spent so much time constructing and deconstructing Magic decks. So what this game does is kind of brings both of my passions to kind of like a standstill. They meet at the head and then they fend each other off. But War of Omens, really interesting. So I guess I'll play a little bit and I'll give you an idea of some of the mechanics. I don't like this deck. I don't know why I went into the game with this deck. This is a deck I built around Sophocatro. The opponent that I'm playing against, Valdorian, is a member of one of the three factions, which I can never remember their names. I'll get back to it. I will read off their factions here eventually. The factions all have different play styles. The opponent, Valdorian, who, I don't know if he's here, he may have just been trying to find a match and he couldn't, and then I showed up. Oh, no, he's playing. Okay. So he's playing like a blue deck. It's more of a denial deck. He doesn't want to let me do the things that I truly want to do with my deck. He wants to deny me of resources, kill my characters. He just made me lose two of my coins right there. So, Yeah, they're like the control deck of this game. I don't particularly like them, even though you ask anybody else, they'd say, "Oh, Pete's a control player." Well, they're liars. So he played that for six turns, attack foes hero, destroy after use. So this is my hero, Sofocotro, and that's his hero. Now the goal is to take them down to zero health, as is traditional in a lot of these types of games. You get these cards out of the left side of the screen, which is called your bank, okay? And the bank includes all 10 types of cards that you had built in your deck. Don't laugh at me. So you start out the game with a bunch of these coined cards already in your deck. And that helps you kind of accelerate into buying them, which they have a gold cost in the upper left-hand corner. Each card has an effect when it's either on the battlefield or when you play it. Anybody with health, like the courtesan, will remain out in the battlefield. Anybody who does not have health is a spell, such as Sibylline Scrolls. So this guy, it seems like, is trying to kill me. I'm trying to accelerate my economy as quickly as possible. Yeah, so he's accelerating into a lot of Belladonnas, which is a pretty good strategy against me, because I need time to get going, but I'm gonna try accelerating everything I do so that I can kill him first. So yeah, he's already got me down to 13 health. That could be a problem. So we'll play collect taxes. And the green faction, a lot of what it does is every card you play pretty much draws you a card. So I really need a lot more of the attacks. This guy intercepts attacks, so he'll help a little bit. See, he helped me. So I think I'm gonna be in trouble this game, pretty sure. Winning online is difficult. I think they have a very small, committed fan base of people who know what they're doing, and there's people like me. And oh, another thing about blues, they're always like stealing your cards, which sucks. Yeah, so I'm really close to death. Really needs like at most two more turns. He might just be able to kill me next turn. Ooh. So in a second here, I'll talk about the resources I'm getting. So I could heal myself up for two, which probably is the best decision. So I will probably die next turn, unless I do something about it. I'm not sure. That guy might help. Nah, I'm dead. I'm gonna just shoot off 15 damage at him real quick, so he can feel my wrath. Could always draw a miracle here. You never know. Didn't happen. Okay. I needed prayer, really, to have a shot. Good game, sir. Okay, so the three clans here, I'll give you more overview. Let me drink some of my soda. There are three factions. There's Vespitole. I'm Italian, you'd never know it. There's Deramech. And there's Metris. Metris are your jerk D-bags who don't want to let you do what you want to do. So each hero also has an ability, so you can see out of all of these Metris characters, like Theodox has 10% to prevent destruction of cards you control. Valdorian can draw a card from your foe's deck, so on and so forth. Mechanics that would seem really broken, but are balanced because it's digital. In real life, you can't be drawing player cards from other players' deck. It seems like it would lead to some people getting shot in a casino somewhere. I can imagine it. But Terramech, which I have a couple Terramech decks, they don't have many characters. Like, characters aren't their things. They have effects that stay on the battlefield for an extended period of time. So, like, if you look up here at that armor thing, that is actually how much damage that thing can deflect. But this, that sun sign in the upper left-hand corner, that means Consolidate will be on the battlefield for 5 turns. And it says, for 5 turns, feed your hero. And then you destroy it after you. So it'll help your hero gain 5 health. Or some of the really high damage ones are like Wagon Bomb. In 4 turns, attack time 16. Now, I'm still not sure of like the exact order of attack, but some characters intercept attacks, so they will take the attacks from, no matter who's targeted, the intercepted attack guys will take the attacks from the others. And then from that point forward, I think it just attacks the lowest health character every single time. I'm pretty sure. I'm not positive. Don't quote me on it. I'm so uneducated, it's ridiculous. But each faction also has 3 different sections of cards. So Metris has Murder, Conspiracy, and Espionage. It's pretty cool concepts. Then you have Vespatoli, which was what I was just playing. It draws you a lot of cards. So you're playing every single card in Vespatoli draws you a card when you play it. So they can lead to big effects. Weird ways of winning with them. Like, the one deck I was playing is built straight around getting skull symbols. And when you get enough skull symbols, you can just shoot the other guy in the face, essentially. Which I'm always up for. But that deck that I was playing works really well against more unit-based decks. And they gain a lot of resources really quickly through their cards. It's cool. I kind of like it. It seems kind of combo-oriented. Like, you can really chain a lot of stuff together. But my favorite faction is Deramech. Deramech's pretty dope. What you're doing with Deramech is you are, like, building hordes to try to gain resources. Which is more of what I am a fan of. So you're trying to amass as many, like, it's almost random resources. So the faction tends to put out a lot of creatures and amass a ton of different resources. So it ends up being pretty versatile. So I've tended more towards Deramech than the other two factions. What else did I want to talk about? I'll talk about that in game. I'll play another multiplayer game here for you guys. Maybe I won't lose this time. So this guy's playing. I'm interested to see somebody play Vespatoli. When did I lose my Italianness? I tend to play much too fast. That guy will die instantaneously. This guy might live a turn. He's really good. So when he's in play, any ally I play will then activate when they're played. So I really like that. This guy has a lot of big cost cards, you can see, as Vespatoli decks tend to. So I am just going to go ahead and get that guy out there. So see, he gained me. Oh, 2 gold, because he was played, and this guy activated him. So one of the things I definitely think is cool is that, there are, like, 4 different resources. There's gold, there's food, there's, death, and there is, magic. And magic can be used as any of the, resources. So this guy's gonna kill my characters a lot, I can tell. Which could make it difficult for me. But I'll just keep playing them, because that's how Deramech works. So you see I leave a coin in my hand usually. You only draw 3 cards on your turn. So if you leave 1 gold in your hand, I figure it leaves you a better shot of Leaves you a better shot of not drawing excess gold. And it leaves you a better shot of drawing your other cards. So Herd of Pigs is really good. I wish I could get that out. This guy's doing so many things, of course. So as you see, I have 4 and I have 3 of magic, so I can just play Herd of Pigs. So unless this guy starts picking up some cards, which he hasn't been, I can start amassing a lot of resources. And then my win con is to have this guy, Wargoats, on turn/feed, so whenever I feed him, give him one of these apples, he will sacrifice my weakest ally and attack x3. And I think that's very good. So these guys are both gaining me random resources every turn. So he could kill off my Herd of Rats if he wanted to. So he got that guy. So the only thing this guy's really missing is a way to refill his bank. But it seems like he's building for the big shot. That guy also helps me win because he uses up my my food resources. So I want another Herd of Pigs out. They're just so tough to kill. So his best thing is like he's gaining a ton of food and a ton of gold. So he can draw. Oh my god, he could probably kill me this turn. Oh my god. Oh, you learn something new every day. There's a card called Bounty that rewards you for having a ton of gold. So remember when I was saying that Vespatole seems like they are the combo deck? I wasn't lying. Alright, so I've played one with Deramech that went just horrendously. So I haven't paid too much attention to my decks, and I should probably rebuild them looking for synergy and stuff, but I've been trying to play as much of the game as possible. I'm going to play one more game, then I'm going to give you my opinions on the game and show you the store and whatnot. So let's see. I could instantly sabotage the dude and lose 2 gold. Which is always good. So matchmaking has been pretty quick, it seems. So I think it's interesting you can see the opponent's bank, so you can kind of plan for what they're doing. My deck wins through trying to hit a couple satchel bombs. Ugh. I'm in such strugglesville in this game. I'm excited to actually get into it and try it, like, after learning how to build a deck. 2 or 4. Maybe in 6 decks. But my main issue seems to be that people understand how to build a deck much better than I do. This guy's just gonna kill me with Orphan Gangs. Also, what I stole was just horrible. There's no way I can be fast enough to kill this guy. I don't think. I should leave Virtual Slaughter in my hand, because really, me drawing it is just absolutely useless. Trying to do is delay. Oh man. One health. Can I do it? Might be able to survive another turn. Oh, yeah. Ugh. Okay. Another loss. Well, I'm obviously not ready for multiplayer. That was great, though. So I enjoyed the game a lot, despite my poor showing there. I really think it's more my decks than my decisions at this point. Since I've played so many of these games, I think I kind of understand how the whole flow of the game works. I don't know the intricacies of the cards in this game yet, and if I learn that, I think I'll stand a fighting shot. I don't think the... if you've played games like this, you enjoy games like this, then I think you're going to find this to be comfortable. Very, very comfortable. I'm making excuses for my performance. So I'll go to the store, okay? There are three different packs, okay? There's an Oak pack, which kind of includes your commons, although there's a possibility of opening uncommons, scarce, rare, and coin, a chance. I have opened uncommons before. Once you get into the silver pack, which costs 300 silver, all the silver I've amassed right now is through playing the game. You can get uncommon and above, and then once you get into the gem pack, you can get rare and coin. So the only thing is the gem packs you cannot purchase without money, I believe. There are starter decks. Which are a little bit pricey, but you can buy them by simply playing. If you were to take enough time to play, you could buy them, which I really think is pretty... it comes with that. Never mind. It's okay. It's pretty cool. Then you get into the gem currency, which is how you buy packs. So a pack that only includes rares would cost you $3. Or four packs for $10. Not bad by TCG standards, especially if you were guaranteed a rare or the ultra rare coins in a pack. I think that's a pretty fair price. But these silver packs, oak packs, very easy to dig into and just earn by playing. So I'll open a silver pack. So one of the interesting things is the card pool is not massive right now, so you can open up doubles of cards. The thing is once you you choose a card so many times, it upgrades, lowering the cost in gold, as well as allowing you to include extra copies in your deck. This one, I'm trying to finish this mercenary off, because I already started. Once I already start something, I gotta keep going. So there's an upgrade path, so it's your commons aren't useless, or your doubles aren't useless. I really want that, one cost herd of rats. think that would be dope. I like these, though. They're good cards. So I'll open up, like, four packs. I got an uncommon pack. That's good. War Rats. I want that to cost five. Grab. I'm looking for a new card here eventually. But I think I've opened most of the common cards. Oh, hey, there you go. That card that just murdered me. Oh my god. This is a genius idea for a deck. I've always been a huge fan of combo decks, so... I may look into trying something like that. Although, it never feels as good when you didn't think of it yourself. So you don't get all the heroes immediately. You have to unlock the heroes. There's different ways to do that. There is soon to be a campaign mode. Currently, you can play against bots on certain levels. Neophyte, Apprentice, Journeyman. And they offer you rewards for beating them. Playing on multiplayer, of course. You just click it, you go. There's a good tutorial. Actually, really, really excellent tutorial. Which teaches you everything you'd like to know about the game really well. Oh, I should have played this game in full screen. Oh well. Okay. And, then, on top of that, you have three different factions to kind of dig into, all with very, very different playstyles, and heroes to dig into with all very, very different playstyles. That stuff, huge fan of that. I know they're bringing in tournament play eventually. They said most likely. But they're focused on getting the campaign done first. Then you have a Android and iOS version, which are going to happen. I was told it's not if, but when. So those will happen, and that's great, because one of the things I definitely want out of one of these games is I want it to be able to be played on mobile, because that is the real benefit of these digital card games, is you can kind of just pick them up, play. The game length of War of Omens games is fantastic. It's like probably 5 minutes. You get through one really fast. You can play a few, you know, an hour without... You can just take a break from doing something. Play it on the toilet. Sure. And I can play it on my tablet. So the touchscreen on my tablet actually works with the game really well. Except when I double tap, it like zooms in. Game gets super wonky. But other than that, it works great. I know they're adding like one card a week at this point, so I'm not sure the direction will take full expansions and everything. Now, what I might not like is the 10 card decks seem interesting. Like you choose your 10 cards, you go in to a game. But it feels a little bit limiting. It's odd. It's different to me. I guess it's just unfamiliar territory to me, I think. As somebody who's always been kind of locked into deck restrictions ever since I started playing MLB Showdown. I was always used to, like, there is a mathematical way you need to build this deck. On the other hand, I think that leaves it open for more people with, like, relatively different collections to compete. So that's, like, a negative to me, because it's unfamiliar, but a positive for the most part. The only other things that scare me are that I'm not sure when a competitive play will happen, but I'd like to see it happen. I really enjoy the tournaments in these games. Like, I've always enjoyed the competitive aspect of Magic, like putting in, you know, a few bucks to join in on this online tournament and then having your deck featured online. One of the other things that scares me is I'm not sure how big their user base is. There's some other games, you know, they have a massive user base, so like you'll always be able to find a match, and I guess I should feel somewhat confident considering I was able to easily find multiplayer games. And this was a Kickstarter success, so that means that they had a good amount of fanfare going in. But I am not quite sure what the user base for this game is, because I'm not sure what the mass appeal is for this game. You know, it's not like a Hearthstone, which has that Blizzard name on it, but I guess I'm not as concerned about it being massively popular, because who cares? I'm concerned about it having people to play with all the time. If I hit that multiplayer button, I want to be able to find a match, which it doesn't seem like is a problem. I guess I'm just spouting off name recognition, because it's comforting. I don't like being uncomfortable, I guess is the whole point of this video. Otherwise, you know, like, this is pretty great. I'm glad it exists. And I'm interested to play more of it. But I don't know if I'll get to. We'll see. So, as you know, this is going up Thursday. This is the second match of round one against Infinity Wars, which that video I did last week. Tomorrow, on Friday, will be the results show, where I make a decision, talk a little bit about both games, what I like, what I don't like, and I make my final decision on one of the two games, being a member of the final four of card games. And I'll also announce what I'll be playing next week for that week of card games. But this was enjoyable. I'm glad you guys got to see me do this and lose a bunch, because it taught you really, truly, how like far you need to come in one of these card games. A week is never enough to like get good at card games. So I'm not like discouraged at all, because I'm the man. And confidence and positivity. It's 2014. It's the year of positivity. So I'm glad you guys had a chance to watch this. Please check back tomorrow. In the meantime, go to indiegamestriplea.com. Got great stuff going up every single day. If you have any questions or comments on this, email us at press@indiegamestriplea.com. If you're a member of the press, if you are a fan, you can just insult me directly at pete@indiegamestriplea.com. So please do that. I just love being slapped in the face with some hard insults from fans. So thanks for watching. I appreciate it. I will see you tomorrow, those of you with a vested interest in this. Those of you who don't, you better like check what you're doing and figure out where your priorities are, because you are obviously, you know, not prioritizing the right things. So thanks. This has been the great digital TCG search of 2014. I'm your host, Pete, and I will see you tomorrow.